Hello everyone, welcome back to another album review, and in this video I'm going to talk about Abiogenesis by KK Null. This is one of the three new albums KK Null released in January 2019. KK Null is one of the first artists in the Japanoise industry, starting his career with some collabs with Merzbow, and then over the years coming more to himself as an independent and solo artist after multiple collabs with so many other respectable names, etc. KK Null has tons of releases that he doesn't just go to your typical harsh noise direction. Most of his stuff can even have elements of power noise or industrial or dark ambient music. Now, when it comes to his new releases over here, it came in my attention that he releases a lot of new music in Bandcamp. And most of the stuff he uploads here kind of seem to take a bit of a different approach, and I'm talking about the album covers of these things that give me a sci-fi or a futuristic feel to them. And what I can tell from these releases is that this is the exact same that happens with the sound of these things as well. Now, this month he released three different projects, and he also made a reissue in digital format on one of his previous albums a few years back. Out of the three albums, Abiogenesis seemed to be the one that got a little bit of a more buzz, that had a little bit of a more attention through it. It was the first out of the three to be released, and so I decided to give this a shot and see what kind of direction KK Null has actually taken in this. Now, the sound of Abiogenesis feels like it's a collage of sound effects from a sci-fi horror movie. And you can pretty much tell just by the album cover of this thing that this one goes more to a futuristic and sci-fi direction with the sound, which is something you don't easily find to lots of noise releases. And I can say that his approach is kind of interesting or kind of rare to find in albums in the genre like this. Not that it's something really revolutionary or something really ahead of its time, but it does sound like something out of sound from the future. Most of the time the track consists of some harsh noise elements and then into some more dark ambient passages throughout of it, and all that with a combination of other sounds that are reminiscent of like shattering glass or like breaking stuff or machines and technology. All of these sounds are combined into a really weird blend where there's not necessarily that much of a connection between it, but that's actually the appeal of the album, is that you never know what to expect, which is kind of the point in albums like this. You don't anticipate structure, you just expect the unexpected. This one in particular is composed and produced between 2015 and 2016, so it's not like we're talking about brand new material over here. This thing is only 3 tracks, 14, 14 and 10 minutes long, and in these 3 tracks, like I said, he has a sound that goes more to the industrial and dark ambient aesthetic rather than just straight up harsh noise, with being direct and abrasive and being right in your face. There are even a few elements over here reminiscent of power noise. So the result is that the sound over here is really crisp, is very well detailed, it's rich in terms of textures and has a really good production behind it. And you know, this is something that we see more and more to become the case with noise music recently. And that's also coming from artists who were mostly known for just raw and abrasive stuff back in the day. Due to the popularity of noise through the digital age, the result is actually albums like this that can manage to appeal to people who are not just necessarily in the underground scene. So KK Null is not an exception of this rule. His sound is way more detailed, way more well produced, and in a sense you can say is more approachable and easier to the ear of a casual listener who at least is looking for some experimental and dark ambient releases, to say the least. And I will also say that this futuristic sound he uses is kind of like the dark ambient side of projects like, but other than that, there's not nothing that much special to the album, or you know, something that sounds really refreshing or really out there for the genre. even if the production on this is great, structurally wise, despite its switch-ups from calm to harsh parts, there are not that many things to mention about this album other than what I just told you already. It's mostly like sound effect and collage music without something that engaging, other than an atmosphere that you don't easily find in an album that goes to genres like this. The track Abiogenesis 3 has some moments of glitch and experimentation that remind me of something out of Ryoji Keda or Tatsura Arai, and that is a nice touch, and I wouldn't be surprised if out of this series of albums, KK Null is actually influenced from artists like Ryoji Keda. Now, Abiogenesis 5, the last track of the album, in my opinion, is the best one out of the three by far, because it's kind of different, it has a nice and kind of creepy industrial sound that repeats itself on some different tempos and on some different occasions throughout the course of the sample, and it's also playing in reverse, and so it gives that feeling of like being in a sci-fi horror movie. And then at some points there is also a sound of a heartbeat, and out of the three is the one track that manages the most to give some feel of tension and anxiety and making you curious but also worried about what's coming next. So, it's not one of my highly recommended industrial and dark ambient albums that you can find. However, it's a short project, it's a good way to start the year, and if you want a kind of different and more unique approach to noise and dark ambient music, give this one a shot, because you might like it more than I did. I'm gonna give this album a 6 out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it? Dislike it? Why? And what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.